Hi everyone, Coach K here. We're going to talk today about the Argentine crisis, the stock crash, the currency crash, and how this relates to Bitcoin and why it makes a really strong case for Bitcoin itself and other cryptocurrencies that have value, which aren't very many, to be completely honest. Now, what I would like for you guys to do is click on that subscribe, like, smash them up, and subscribe, share, all that kind of good stuff to support the channel as I continue on. Now, don't forget to stay to the end because I'm going to show you charts about what actually has been happening. So it won't take me very long. This video will be only 7 or 8 minutes. Let's get started. The first thing that we see right here is Argentine stocks and crypto and currencies, not cryptocurrencies, have crashed on election surprise. Mauricio Macri was the president of Argentina, okay? And what happened was, is his running mate, the person who is running against him, Fernandez, he is connected in with the Kirchners. And those people were in charge from 2003, and there's a whole ton of indictments and things about them being corrupt. So this is why you could see some type of election surprise and also, crashes and panic. Okay, so this is what we're going to expect to see. And what you also are going to see, which is really interesting, is they're trying to kind of save them. So this is Alberto Fernandez who won. And everyone's so happy for him. But the lady that ran with him, his running mate, is really the one who's going to be pulling the strings, which is named Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner. I think I say it wrong. Now, why is that important? Well, she is indicted on 11 different charges of corruption. And, even within their own economy, they said, I don't think there's a way to sugarcoat this. We're likely going to see a panic market reaction. And they did, very, very much so. Let's look on the other side. Now, what are the banks trying to do? Because in a matter of hours, they shed 37% of the value of their stocks. The national currency lost almost 30% of its value before gaining ground and closing at 18% lower. The government used heavy artillery to contain the damage by primary election results held on Sunday. It raised interest rates on its 7-day notes from 63% to 74% and used $50 million to back its currency in the market. So basically, huge amounts of people freaking out. Now think about this. A Wall Street, some Argentine stocks traded at 60% lower. Imagine like tomorrow Amazon trading at 60% lower. How many people would that affect? So this is a whole country we're talking about, not just a few people. And yes, they've been riddled with economic issues and financial issues, but just it's crazy to think how much this actually affects their own economy and their own people. So the socialist who is indicted with 11 corruption charges, she didn't win, but the connection to her did. And we have seen this is the index. So it was way up here at the start of the day and dropped all the way down there. I'll show you that in a more detailed chart in a second. But Ms. Kirchner's comeback plan was met with a lot of surprise. A lot of people were skeptical. It's because she said that like Macri wasn't really doing anything and people lost a lot of their, they lost a lot of the feeling that he could actually do anything. So it shows it has a pawn in government for her. The Argentine bank is trying to step in and help. It's going to lead to a lot of problems. Let's be really honest here. And then we see this is her. Alberto Fernandez is the one who won. And Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner is right here. Now, why is this important? It's very important for Bitcoin, actually, because I'm going to show you some stuff to make a very compelling case right now. So don't go anywhere. I'm going to show you this in the next couple minutes. So give me a couple minutes of your time to show you why. Here's the Argentine peso from February of 2013. It is down 91% as of right now. 91%, 14.8% by the close on the day, but 91% overall. That is insane. Why would that happen? Inflation, printing, having banks, central banks print money and print money and print money, making the value of your dollar less valuable, less valuable, less valuable. Okay? And we look at the stock market and we see that at the close, it was down 43, 44%, okay, in one day and dropped as low as 48% in one day. This is, by statistic, the second worst stock market crash in one day since the last 70 years. We're talking about World War II 70 years, like that long ago. This is insane. This is one of the worst by far. Now, what does that mean for Argentina? Well, it means that A, there's a reason why so many people over there have been pushing their money into Bitcoin. I have personal friends that are there. I have a lot of people that I've worked with that are over there. And most of them, because I'm in crypto, are in Bitcoin. And they say, when you ask them, are a lot of people using Bitcoin in Latin America, Brazil, and Argentina? They're like, absolutely. And I said, why? I asked one of my friends that. And he said, we don't want to be people like in Venezuela that have no money. We want to actually put our money in something that stays valuable. And even if it drops 40%, it's not as bad as what we have right now. So imagine that. Imagine having a US dollar and being like, it's not as bad as right now. If our US dollar became worth 50 cents, we might as well put it in Bitcoin because that has, it could go down 80%, but it always comes back. You imagine the thought process behind that, being in a country where that's your currency and you have that little faith in it. This is why Bitcoin actually is around, because of quantitative easing, because of bailouts. So it was created for that reason. And the stuff that's happening in the stock market and Argentina peso, this is exactly why it was created in the first place. We can't bail people out and like reset the clocks and then have people be broke. So really interesting, compelling case. Now, if we want to look at Bitcoin, let's do that. Let me just delete this so you guys can see it a little bit clearer. But at the start on Bitfinex, this is March, okay? This is March. It's like $60 Bitcoin. This is not the bottom. The bottom was even way lower. But we're just going to start in 2013 when it was traded on Bitfinex, okay? Around the exact same time as where the Argentine peso started, right? This was in February of 2013. We're going to go to March, 1 month later, of 2013. Now, if we just go till today, just right now, we have 11,900%. If you had $100 in the bank, you can add two zeros to that, which would make it $1.19 million worth of value. If you put in $100 in February of that year, that's how much percentage it would have gone up, okay? If Bitcoin was worth $1, okay? It's not worth $1 there, but if Bitcoin was worth $1 and you put in $100 there, it'd be worth $1.19 million. Now let's look at on the other end. If you had taken money in the same time and put $100 into the Argentine peso, it would be worth $9. Nine. Yes, actually. And there's countries like Venezuela and Brazil and Turkey and Greece, and people will tell you that this has happened in more than just one place before. And that is why we have to look at this and go, okay, this actually is a problem. And now we understand where the case for Bitcoin comes for all of this. Because obviously, if we have the Argentine peso crisis, we have another case for Bitcoin. Absolutely. And this is going to keep happening, everybody. Wake up. It's going to happen over and over and over again. And this is something that you need to prepare. No one's telling you, and I'm not a financial advisor, but no one's telling you to put all your money into cryptocurrency. But if you see what's happening here, you know that it might be a safe haven. And this is also why the gold market has started to rise swiftly in the last year or two, because other people see that not only is the Argentine stock market and currency at a volatile state, so are most other stock markets, especially the SPX, the DJI, and others around the world that are literally at all-time highs. And eventually, whatever goes up, as we've learned with Bitcoin, will eventually come down before it resets. So prepare yourself, make sure that you're ready for what's going to come. And this is why the Argentine peso crisis has made a very good case for things like cryptocurrency and Bitcoin. If you like this video, guys, do comment. I would love to hear what you guys would like to hear, what you think about this video. I would also really enjoy if you guys put in some in the comments some of the coins that you would like me to do TA on the other videos that I'll be doing this week, as well as the live feed every Monday and Friday at 5:45 to 6 p.m. Thai Bangkok time. That's GMT plus 7. I'll see you guys then. I hope you have a great day. Coach K signing out.